All right, let's try it again. You admit that the fingerprints we got off the bike are yours.
I don't know if they're mine or not. I mean, if you say they are, I guess they are. I mean, Ned Ashton is a friend of mine. He's a friend of mine. And I sat on his bike and maybe I touched it then.
You've touched it? We lifted your prints from the handlebars, from the seat, from the gas tank.
I don't care. I didn't ride on it. No.
And you were on that road and you ran a girl down.
No, I didn't. Why are you doing this?
We've got your fingerprints, Phoebe.
I think this has gone on long enough.
We got a skid mark from the bike. We also have the victim's purse and a bloodied handkerchief that was hers. Now, where the hell is she?
I don't
Chief
know.
Lewis, if you're charging my daughter with a crime, I want my attorney present.
She hasn't been charged yet.
That's right. She hasn't been charged yet. But you could be.
I don't know anything. I don't.
You could be an accessory to theft, leaving the scene of an accident, and possibly assault.
No.
Look, why are you covering this up, Phoebe? Are you trying to protect somebody? Are you trying to protect Decker? Because if you are, it's not worth it. Believe me. The only person in this whole damn mess that's worth protecting is the woman who got hit by that motorcycle. Now, if you know something, damn it, tell us.
All right, now that's enough. Now, you're no cop, so you just shut up. And as far as you're concerned, you make one more accusation against my daughter, and I'll sue you and this entire police department.
Now, Chief Lewis?
Yeah.
The phone call.
Okay, all right, listen, everybody, listen. Let's just calm down a little bit, all right, huh?
I don't feel very good. Can you go home, please?
All right, look, Phoebe, you and your dad, you can go now.
Make sure you're available if I need you for questions.
We'll see how you like answering some questions as soon as I get a hold of my attorney.
Keep
listening. Come on, sweetheart.
Yeah. Okay.
This doesn't make any sense at all. I mean, what's she afraid of?
You tell me. Decker's your brother.
Hey, come on, man. You met Decker. I admit he's a wise guy. He's a con man. But violence is not his style.
Yeah, but what about his friends? We know nothing about them.
Yeah, all right.
What if they were with Felicia when she made the call? What if they forced her into it to get us off his back?
I don't know. The only person that can answer that question is Felicia. Phoebe's not going to answer it for us, that's for sure.
Oh, here's a good one for you. We just got a phone call from a woman in Atlantic City.
What, did she see Felicia?
No. She said she saw Phoebe Dawson, dealing five-card Monte.
Now, what the hell do you expect? I mean, you send flyers out to a couple states, and you're going to get all kinds of false alarms. It's a pain in the butt.
Yeah, well, that's what it looks like now. But you can bet that if Phoebe Dawson was still missing, that her parents would be grateful for any lead there.
Not a bad idea.
Very good idea. I think it's worth a shot?
You're damn right I do.
This is so much fun. I cannot remember when I have had so much fun. I mean, I can't remember. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I can't remember very much, but if I could remember, I'm sure I would remember that I haven't had so much fun in my life.
Damn.
What? We got over almost $1 zillion there, it looks like.
No, look. Mostly small bills. I mean, it's a good haul for what we did, but this ain't going to get us out of town.
I'm not used to seeing you worry like this so much. Don't worry about it. I promise I won't spend too much more money on all that expensive food.
Yeah, well, just the same, I'm gonna hit the streets again, all right? No, I'm gonna hit the streets. You stay here.
Why not? You said I was getting good.
You listen to me, all right? This is a gambler's town, Atlantic City. I mean, people are very smart here. They're very knowledgeable. And me, I'm just a small town hustler. Eventually, they're gonna find out and catch me. You, I'm not gonna take any risks with you.
But if this is dangerous, I don't want anything to happen to you either.
Listen, I'll be careful. I'll just make enough to tide us over, and I'll be right back, okay?
Well, how long will it take?
Just long enough for you to relax and think about where you want to go next, all right? Now, who knows? I may hit it big, and we'll leave this town the same way we came, in style, right? Come on, babe. Come on.
Promise me you won't take any chances.
You just think about where we're gonna go. All right? I'm big town, small town. Hell, we'll hit them all. All right? All right. Stay here.
Looks like a good description of Felicia. Now we just need the paragraph about where she was last seen.
Last seen.
Look, I can't do this. Give it to somebody else.
Okay.
Sam says you might have a lead on Felicia, some girl you've been questioning?
Oh, no, that girl. She was the girl in Nana's missing persons case. I tell you, this is going to take a lot longer than we thought, but She knows a lot more than she's telling us.
Lisa gave us an idea. We sent a flyer out on Felicia. Maybe something will turn up.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. What else are we going to do? It's a long shot.
Yeah, it seems like we're both into long shots. At least I know where Bobby is and that she's safe.
Well, sounds like your life is together.
You know, you can think that you're falling in love with someone, but until you lose them, or you nearly lose them, you're never sure. I mean, I've known Bobby for so long, I thought we would always agree on everything. The only good I can find is that at least I know her side of the relationship right now.
Yeah. Well, that makes two of us.
And I never thought about what Felicia went through when I was missing.
And I always thought about what I was going through. And what was happening to me. This is something, you know? I'll tell you what, though. When we get her back, I am going to make it up to her.
Thank you.
Well, I've got my mom working on a picture of Decker, but it looks like it might take a while.
Yeah, well, we can always send out a second flyer.
Here, do those things work?
Oh, sometimes. Usually they just bring out a bunch of crank calls.
Yeah, well, one thing's in our favor. For runaways like Phoebe usually wear a lot of disguises, and we have no reason to believe that Felicia doesn't want to be found.
This is really a pretty good reproduction. She sure is a beautiful lady, isn't she? I've never seen this picture before. Where'd you get it?
It's mine.
Oh, Phoebe. Glad I finally got a hold of you.
What the hell do you want, Decker?
What kind of thing is that? I'm just calling a friend.
Oh, yeah, you're a real good friend. Listen, I can't talk very long, okay? My parents are not really crazy about this whole thing.
Well, they're just probably getting worried about you.
Yeah.
They're not used to dealing with the cops, I guess, huh?
My dad has never even gotten a parking ticket.
Is there somebody out there?
No, it's a tube. I'll turn the TV on.
Who's that? Who the hell's that?
Oh, that's nobody.
Oh, yeah.
When you were talking to the cops, did they ask any questions about me or the girl?
Don't worry about it. I didn't tell them anything, okay?
I knew I could count on you, Phoebe.
Yeah, well, don't flatter yourself. I'd have told them absolutely everything if it wouldn't have incriminated me, too, okay?
That's a good point for you to keep in mind, yes.
Well, here's a really good point for you to keep in mind. That chick's boyfriend and some other guy are killing themselves trying to find her. And you know what? I have a feeling they will, too.
I don't think I'm good.
How's this for a fashion statement?
That's nice.
What? What went wrong now? What's the matter?
No, nothing. I didn't make very much money out on the streets again. Look, do you mind if we stay here for another day or so?
No, I'd love to.
Great, thanks.
You know, it's really kind of strange because I just have this feeling that I've had some good memories here before. It's crazy, isn't it? You remember what Jimmy said? That I was good luck in the casino? Maybe we should go back and try to make some money and increase our bankroll.
Yeah, you definitely have the gambling spirit. But we should hang on to what we got. At least until, you know, there's a sure thing, you know?
It's too bad this isn't valuable. But then again, I'm kind of glad that it isn't, because if it was, then I'd have to get rid of it, and I don't want to do that.
You look good. I mean, it looks good when it sits on you. It's like you and Jackson, they're meant for each other.
And the pink tights.
Mm-hmm. No, we don't know about a reward as of yet, but you will be the first one I call. Thank you again.
Hi.
Anything about Felicia doing?
No.
Hey, Ruby told me that you've been here since sunup, man. You should get some rest, you know, take a break.
Well, Mouse, I'd hate to leave all these useless phone calls I've been getting from people identifying Phoebe.
Phoebe. Wait, I thought she turned up.
Yeah, well, the rest of the world doesn't know it. How do you go about recalling 1,000 flyers out there floating around?
Well, why don't you take a break, read the paper, I'll answer the phone for you. You know, I'll be like your secretary.
My secretary?
Yeah.
Why don't you start by making me a fresh pot of coffee?
First of all, I'm not going to be that kind of secretary.
What the hell are you doing here anyway? I thought you had a job at Windermere.
Nah, I quit that. I got nothing but time, man. I'm all yours.
Well, here. Why don't you go down to the dock and pass these flyers out of Felicia? Maybe then I'll get the phone call I'm waiting for.
Colton?
Did I?
Yeah. Gosh, that sounds really familiar.
Well, nobody you know. Let's just eat. Sorry about the wait.
Strange, isn't it?
What's that?
That name, Colton. I mean, I like it, but is he a good friend of yours?
Yeah, right. Good friend. Do you want some more coffee or juice or something? Here, have a bacon bit.
I thought you didn't have any friends in Atlantic City.
Who told you I did?
You.
Oh, good memory.
Yeah, pretty good for somebody who can't even remember who she is.
Look, there's nothing wrong with just living for now, you know? I mean, who needs all of yesterday's problems anyway?
I do. I want to know who I am and where I've come from. It's driving me crazy.
Look, I'm just a friend. I just wanted to help you out, you know?
I know. I know I'm sorry. It's just that this city makes me feel sad about something and I don't understand it. I don't think I've ever been here before.
Well, in that case, let's blow town. Put a smile on both our faces, huh?
Do we have the money for leave?
No. But I can fix that. With the help of my lovely assistant, Phoebe, the envelope, please.
What? What envelope?
Come on, I saw you stash some of that hotel stationery back at the hotel. I'm your first.
Oh, yeah, right.
Give me a pen, too.
I think I must have been a pack rat in a former life or something.
Yeah, your sense of humor's coming back. That's really nice.
So what's the envelope for?
It's to con this, hotel manager.
How are you going to do that?
You just watch, all right? Maybe you can figure out how it's done. Excuse me. Sir, do you have a $20 bill? I have all these singles here that I need changed for.
Yeah, oh, there you go.
Thanks a lot.
Good.
Target the warehouses and the truck loading areas. Anybody coming in or out, make sure they got a lot of flyers going.
Yeah, sure, you got it.
Well, what's the problem?
Oh, I was just thinking that I should have made you that pot of coffee.
I've got the coffee. What is it?
No, I shouldn't say anything.
What is it? What's the matter?
You know, Frisco, it seems really obvious to me that Felicia doesn't want to be found by you. You know, maybe she should just follow through on this promise of yours about leaving town when Domino's caught.
You know, Mouse, sometimes promises are destined to be broken.
Would it have made it easier for you to keep your promise if you knew that you wouldn't have to leave alone? Look, Frisco, I would go with you, you know, if you want, and if you just ask.
Well, that's very sweet of you.
No, Frisco, I'm not being sweet, okay? I just want to be with you, that's all, okay?
Come here. Come here. Did I ever tell you that you remind me exactly of Felicia the first time I met her?
Right.
No, I mean it. She had her hair rolled up just like you, under a cap. She looked just like a boy. And it wasn't until her cap fell off and her hair fell down that I saw her. And I knew then that this was the girl for me.
Well,
My sentiments exactly. Wow. Now that's going to happen to you someday. You're going to meet somebody that you're going to feel that way about.
Great, I can hardly wait.
But, like my mother would have told me, take your time. Don't rush it.
Oh, great. Do you have any more advice for me, or can I just go pass out these flyers?
As a matter of fact, I want you to get your job back at Windermere.
Frisco, that was scut work.
No, I don't care. Get your job back. Do something. Make a little money. Then you can go buy a couple nice little outfits, like the one you wore at the club.
Wait, I'm really surprised you even remember.
I remember.
Good luck with Felicia. Give me my hat. Goodbye.
Felicia, looks like I'll need all the luck I can get. Is this going to be enough?
Well, give me as many as you can spare. You know, they're dispatching them downstate by police helicopter, so take advantage.
I appreciate this.
No problem.
How's the arson investigation coming with Anna?
Unfortunately, about as well as the search for Felicia.
So much for our WSB training, huh?
Hey, wait a minute. It's way too early to be discouraged, Frisco.
Well, patience is not one of my virtues.
Well, hang in.
Well.
Hi, Colton.
How did you know I was here?
I didn't. Where's Anna?
She's out for the day. Any messages?
No, I need to talk to her.
About what?
I think that's my business, don't you?
I was just leaving, guys.
Yeah, well, that makes two of us.
Hey, wait a minute. Now, if you've got some information on Felicia, you better tell me. I'm still in charge of this so-called investigation, if you forgot.
So-called is exactly right. I don't think you've done a damn thing to be proud of.
You feel you could do better?
Well, I'm doing better right now, yeah.
Well, good. Would you care to elaborate and fill me in?
Just butt out, because I don't need your help and I don't want your help. I can do it myself.
Who's playing the hero now?
Look, buddy, you may have some tin deputy's badge, but I'm not taking any orders from you.
Do you want to find Felicia or not? Now, it's not by choice, but we're in this together, so get your priorities straight.
All right. Look, I got a call from Decker. Now, he gave me some cockamamie story about being in Wyoming somewhere, but I have proof that he's not in Wyoming. I don't know where the hell he is, but he's a lot closer than Wyoming.
Well, you really like this con, don't you?
Like it? I love it, and it's so easy, too.
Yeah, well, it took me years of practice.
Honestly?
Honestly? No, honestly had nothing to do with it.
I get it.
I do my thing. Why don't you just pick something out? You know, a little souvenir to remember Atlantic City by, huh?
Maybe I already do.
All sales final, right? I don't think we're going to be coming back here.
Excuse me.
I have a bunch of bills here that I need a $20 bill for an exchange. Would that be fine? Thanks a lot. My mother, she's doing so well financially. I gotta send this off to her as soon as possible. I have time for a
Well, thanks for your trouble. I appreciate it.
Hey, you're $1 short.
What, are you sure?
Count it yourself.
Well, I trust you. I'm sure I'm $1 short. I'll tell you what I'll do.
I'll give you this. You keep the 20, all right? I'll go out to the car and I'll get the rest that I owe you, all right?
You're the punk that pulled that con on me.
What the?
Get
it! Hey, wait a minute! What's going on here?
You're not gonna get away from this! Help! Somebody stop them!
Thank you very much.
Well, you're welcome.
You know, this sure is fun working together, isn't it?
Certainly has made my career.
Shall we?
All right, look, we've got the fact that Decker and Phoebe have lied. They're hiding information about Felicia.
It's possible that Decker might be holding Felicia against her will. I did hear a woman's voice in the background.
Yeah, but that didn't sound like a woman being held against her will.
Yeah, but why would he try to conceal the woman's identity unless he was covering something up?
Maybe she was playing smart. The prisoner cooperating?
Or the prisoner who's been seduced by her captor.
Well, let's go with what we've got.
Yeah, okay.
You've narrowed it down to a phone call. Now let's get the location, huh?
All right. What are you doing?
I'll try to tap into the phone company's records.
You don't believe in dial-in direct?
Well, now you have a job to do. Why don't you find out what you can from the phone company and we'll compare notes?
Fine.
If you don't decide to hold out on me.
Well, what the hell is that crack supposed to mean?
Well, I mean, Decker is your brother. You're related to Lucy, right? I mean, your bloodline's a little shaky.
Look, I don't like being here any more than you like having me here, okay?
Well, then go, and we'll talk later.
Forget it. I'm not going anywhere. I'm going to stick to you like glue, all right? And when we turn up a lead and we find Felicia, I'm going to be right there with you. Because I wouldn't trust you alone with her for 5 seconds, buddy.
Good. You shouldn't. Where does this leave us?
Nowhere.
Well, we got a couple hundred towns. We can make a cheap phone call to poor Charles.
Yeah, so much for this state-of-the-art high-tech police computer.
Donnelly Devane Investigations. This is Frisco Jones.
Frisco, it's Manny Stark from Atlantic City. Did you ever find that girl you were looking for, Phoebe?
Yeah,
she's safe at home in Connecticut with her parents.
Not anymore, she's not.
I got a guy here who saw her and the guy that she was traveling with. She was wearing some kind of crazy clothes, and when she and her friend pulled a con on the guy, he grabbed her wig.
All right, that sounds like our Phoebe. What about the guy?
A young, good-looking, kind of reddish hair, heavy eyebrow.
That's him. Listen, you did good work, thank you.
Thanks.
What is it?
Well, I don't know what this means. It looks like they've spotted our man Decker in Atlantic City, and reportedly with Phoebe.
Phoebe. Did you remember to turn on the phone machine?
Why don't you get it?
Phoebe. I think we lost him. He's fine.
Look at all the stuff I got. Let's do it again.
Nah, I don't think that's a good idea just now. We gotta sneak back to the hotel, get our stuff, come out.
And then what? Go to the casino?
Well, maybe. Let's let these guys cool out first, all right?
Okay, I'll keep an eye out for them.
Good idea. Second thought, let's just get out while the getting's good, huh?
Yeah. Sure.
Mr. Dawson and Phoebe are here to see you.
Good, bring him in. Spockery's gonna call him, will you?
Sure will.
I want to thank you, Mr. Dawson, for bringing Phoebe down here.
Well, I don't appreciate this continued harassment of my daughter. I'd like to have my lawyer present.
Well, there'd be no necessity for that. We have no intention of pressing charges.
Well, you say that now, Commissioner, but I'd still like to have him here. Now, I can make a phone call
right
now.
No, Pop, we don't need any lawyers or anything. I don't know anything. I told them that I don't know anything about
that. You know what I think, Phoebe? I think there's something you're not telling us.
And I think you're lying through your teeth.
I'll bet this is the crummiest motel in Philadelphia.
No, not quite. Believe me, I know.
You sure know how to treat a girl just so swell, don't you?
Well, that was a close call back in that souvenir shop, if you remember. We could be in jail right now instead of here. This is a little more comfortable, you know. We're just going to lay low for a few days. Is that all right with you?
I know what you're thinking. You're thinking that it's all my fault that we got caught. But it's not. It was your fault, and I'm the one that went in to bail us out.
Hey, would you relax? Would you take a pill or something? Just lighten up. Phoebe, you are my lucky charm. Don't you know that by now? I'm not gonna leave you. Well, what is that? What are you thinking that for?
I can't help it. I'm scared. I don't know anybody else.
Don't worry, all right? We're in this together.
To the end.
Good.
I don't know what I'd do without you.
Look, why don't we just settle down here, all right? Get unpack and everything.
Could we get some food? I haven't eaten since breakfast.
Yeah, right. Yeah, good idea, food. I'm kind of hungry myself. Not so good.
We're out of money again?
Almost. It was a bus tickets and 2 days in advance for the room.
Mm.
Yeah. Look, I know my way around Philly pretty good. I'm going to go out, get a few guys, hustle up a poker game or something. How about it?
It'll give me a chance to try my symptoms.
Wait. First off, I'm going to bring the people back here, okay? And second, your wig. You don't go out without it. You can't.
Oh, I hate that wig. It gives me a headache. Don't you think I'll look just fine without the wig?
Me? Yes, I... You look great. That's the problem. You're a pretty girl. I mean, people, they remember pretty girls. With the wig on and everything, you're not going to...
Why?
Why mess with success?
Right.
Okay. Let's just... Here we go. I like this one. Why don't you put this one on?
Okay.
All right. Okay, I'm gonna go. You practice your signals.
Right.
Right. Walk up when I go.
Yeah.
Frisco, I've explained to Mr. Dawson here that as this is an informal meeting, there'll be no lawyers present, as he requested.
That's fine. No need for lawyers at all. Also, Robert, being as we're so close to this case, I thought we might do the questioning, if you don't mind.
Be my guest.
All right, Phoebe. We know that your fingerprints were on Ned Ashton's motorcycle.
Well, I leaned on it. I told you that...
Right, you leaned on it. You told us.
And you were with Decker when you did that, right? When you leaned on the bike.
Did I say that the other day?
We know you were with Decker.
Yeah, but it was just that one day.
That one day when he took the motorcycle.
You know he took it?
That's right.
Well, I don't have anything to do with that.
No, we know that. That's fine.
Where was Decker going?
I don't know.
Did he ever mention anything about Atlantic City?
No.
A man fitting his description was just seen there.
So?
There was also a girl with him. Wearing wigs like you wear and the kind of clothes you wear.
Well, I've never been to Atlantic City. I've never been to Atlantic City.
But you were with him on the motorcycle,
no,
wherever you were.
No, yes, but we just went for a little ride.
You've been lying to us the whole time, Phoebe.
Well, no, I told him not to steal it. I didn't steal it. I told him that it was a...
You had an accident, didn't you?
We didn't hurt her. She just got bumped.
Didn't hurt who?
Nobody.
Who?
That girl.
That's enough. What girl?
The blonde girl.
What blonde girl are you talking about?
I don't know.
Where is she?
You tell me everything you know, and you tell me right now.
Where the hell is Felicia? What did Decker done with
her? That's enough. Now, this questioning will stop immediately, or I'll stop a lawsuit on this department.
Let me suggest something to you.
Wait. Now, Mr. Dawson's absolutely correct here, Frisco. You of the voluntary nature of this meeting, there are no lawyers present. Why don't you take Phoebe outside and we'll all get a chance to calm down.
I'm taking her home right
now. You tried that, and I'll arrest her as a material witness in a hit and run. Then you're gonna need a lawyer. You step outside and then we'll try this again. Please.
All right. Come along, Phoebe.
Damn it, Robert. What are we wasting time for? I mean, it's obvious Felicia's in Atlantic City with this guy, Decker.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Much appreciated. That was the Atlantic City Police Department. Now, I had to run a check on that envelope that Decker used in the con. Came from a hotel that did a positive ID on both Felicia and Decker.
Fantastic.
I checked out. I have to get over to General Hospital to do a check on an autopsy. In the meantime, chaps, why don't you arrive at some kind of a plan that finds this woman without trashing the countryside?
Well, he's right, isn't he?
He usually is. That's what's so irritating.
Great. So, what do we do?
Well, let's try the opposite approach. If we can't get to Felicia, let's see if we can get Felicia to come to us.
No, Decker, I don't know. You haven't won a pot yet, have you?
Bernie, the night is young. I am just warming up.
Anybody need anything?
No, not fine.
I could use a change of luck, actually. Now, just serve. Don't worry about it, all right?
Yeah.
She is quite a looker, isn't she, there?
Yeah.
She's new in town. Okay. Bernie, high card. You bet.
Bet 20.
Got it. Real cute.
Right there.
All right. And around one more time.
50.
And I'm gonna raise you 50 on that one.
I'm in. Too rich for me.
I got garbage.
Call. Okay. Ooh, straight to the queen.
Damn.
Yeah, I told you my luck was changing. Hey. Don't I know you?
I don't think so.
No, like I said, Bernie, she's new in town. Leave the girl alone.
Yeah, I know. Could swear I've seen you somewhere, though. That was your picture.
What picture?
I don't know. It'll come to me.
Hey, what is this chit-chat here? Let's play a game. We're here to play a game. We're going to play a game. Your deal. Ready?
I'm in.
Tell us the truth. That's all we want to know.
Telling you again. If you continue to browbeat her like this, the questioning will stop and not resume again without
Mr.
my lawyer.
Mr. Dawson, please. You have a word.
Okay. All right. I'm sorry. All right, Phoebe. When you left them, she was unconscious. Is that right?
Yeah, but you could tell she wasn't hurt or anything.
And you never saw either one of them again?
No, I told you that already.
Okay. You did talk with Decker, though.
Yeah, he called me once.
And did he say where he was calling from? Did he tell you where he was at all?
No. He just wanted to know what I told the police.
Did you tell him that you'd been lying the entire time?
That's it. Come along, Phoebe. We're going home. We have no authority to keep you here any longer.
Phoebe, you listen to me. You just better not leave town, you hear? Because if I want you for questioning, you better be available.
Well, we're batting 1,000, aren't we?
The Dawsons are leaving. Are you guys through with this room?
Yeah. Unfortunately, yes. Thank you.
Sure are. Listen, Chief, is there any way that we can get a phone tap set up on Phoebe's phone just in case Decker calls her back?
Simple missing persons case?
No way.
Hey, this is not a simple... We're talking about Felicia.
Look, all right. Tell you what. I got an idea. How about if I try to set up a hotline?
You can do that?
Sure. Let me see what I can do.
All right. You said you had an idea earlier.
Yeah, well, it's a long shot, but it might answer a question for us.
What question?
Well, is Felicia really in trouble, or did she leave on purpose to get away from the two of us?
I'm out, too.
Just you and me, Decker?
Yeah. I'm going 50 on this. And 50 more.
Confident?
Very. Well, I'm a cautious man. I'm gonna call. Full house, tens over fives. Better tenants, queens over eights.
Damn. Let me have another beer.
With booze it is.
Money. Hey, I remember now. You were on a poster.
Poster?
and not a poster, a flyer, at the post office. The hair was different, but now it was you.
She was on a wanted poster?
I'm sure it was her.
Yeah, I've seen that poster. Yeah, it looks just like her. But Phoebe's not missing. There you go, huh?
No. How could I be missing? I mean, I'm right here.
Exactly right. She's right here. How could she be missing?
What did it say she was wanted for?
Wanted for? This is crazy. My girl is not on anybody's wanted list, except mine. Right, baby?
You say so.
I do, because it's true. All right? I mean, don't you think I'd know if my own girl was missing? I have a clue, huh? Come on. All right, my deal.
Yeah, let's play.
Annie up.
Let's go. There.
Okay. You guys want a rematch?
Thank you.
You know where I am.
Nice meeting. Incredible how much you look like that broad on the poster. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. You were great. You know what we're going
to
do now?
What?
You know what? We're going to find the best restaurant in town. Celebrate. All right? Get ready. Let's go.
While we're out, can we look for that poster? I'd like to see if I look like that girl.
I forgot where that poster was.
Well, let's look for it. Maybe we'll get lucky.
I got it. I know somebody. That's the door.
Hey!
Sorry I'm late, man. Where is she?
Well, happy birthday, BJ, from Uncle Frisco. Here's your present.
Your present?
You're going to have to open it now.
Present.
There you go. I'm going to leave it right down there, okay? Don't forget about it.
Officially make yourself...
What a big blow's hard.
Birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear BJ. Happy birthday to you.
Get right
after. Water.
Ooh. Oh, can you get it? Can you get it?
Oh, no. Oh, those trains.
That
now,
good.
So, have you heard anything more about Felicia?
Yeah, we got a tip. She's in Atlantic City.
Well, I'm surprised you're not there.
Well, I'm using my better sense. Listen, I can't stay long. I'm going to try an idea to find her.
Okay. I'm just glad you came.
All right. What's the word with Bobby? Is she coming back soon?
I don't know. But she was having a good time showing Lucas to Luke and Laura and said to tell you hello from Luke and Laura.
Oh, great. Listen, I got a split, man. Wish me luck with this idea, all right?
I do. I'm glad you came.
I'll see you soon. Excuse me.
Yeah.
Okay.
Are you having a good time?
Wonderful. This lobster is so wonderful, but it's so expensive.
Hey, tonight, enjoy. Tonight, money, no object, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Decker.
What?
Am I your girlfriend? You said at the game tonight that I was your girl. Am I?
What, is that important?
Yeah, it's real important. I'm starting to remember things. Little things like, well, I know that I like lobster, but I don't remember other things like if we have a relationship or not. Do we?
Yeah, sure. That's good, huh?
Then why do you sleep on the couch?
It's not that kind of relationship. I mean, we're a team, partnership, you know? And the way we did tonight, damn good team. You don't do anything to screw up that type of teamwork. Yeah, I mean, romance. No. All right?
Yeah, okay. No nookie.
No nookie.
Do you like me?
I like you. Eat your lobster.
I think that the wine went right to my head.
Yeah, you deserve it. For the job you did tonight, I'm proud of you, baby.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Thanks. If we both been stronger, I'm just kind of tired. I'm just gonna take a shower. We can both go to bed, all right?
Sounds like a good idea to me.
No. This is not what I meant. Remember?
No.
Nookie. Right, no
right.
Nookie. Okay, good girl.
Good girl.
Charles, New York. Their message is personal to someone they both care very much about. First, Mr. Colton Shore.
Thanks, Tiffany. Felicia, if you're out there and you're watching right now, I just want you to know that I'm worried about you, and I want you to pick up a phone and just call us and tell us that you're all right and come home. We can work it out, okay? Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Shore. And now, Mr. Frisco Jones.
There are a lot of people that love you here, Felicia. I know it's been very difficult for you. And we forced you into a situation that you just don't know what to do. All we ask is that we know that you're all right. Because that's our main concern. Is that you're all right. So, please call us.
Thank you both, gentlemen. And if our viewing audience has seen this woman that is going to be on the screen, please call our toll-free hotline number, 1-800-FELICIA. That's 1-800-FELICIA, and all information will be strictly confidential. That's all for tonight. I'm Tiffany Hill for WLPC. Thank you, and good night.
Decker!
Yeah?
I don't know who I am now.
A lot of people that love you here, Felicia. I know it's been very difficult for you. And we force you into a situation that you just don't know what to do. All we ask is that we know that you're all right. Because that's our main concern. Is that you're all right. So, please call us.
Thank you both, gentlemen. And if our viewing audience has seen this woman that is going to be on the screen, please call our toll-free hotline number, 1-800-FELICIA. That's 1-800-FELICIA, and all information will be strictly confidential. That's all for tonight. I'm Tiffany Hill for WLPC. Thank you, and good night.
That's me. I'm Felicia. Decker! I know who I am. I'm the girl on the TV right there.
You are Phoebe Dawson.
No! No, and you're Decker. You're the guy that worked in that bar, the hat trick in Ohio.
So? What about it?
What am I doing in a motel room with you?
There's a logical, simple explanation for this, and I'll tell you what it is.
No.
Listen. You're not going anywhere. We got to talk. All right?
I'm not going to hurt you.
Hey. Promise you won't run? Promise?
All right.
Look. I know you're a little mixed up right now. You're a little scared. All I want to do is help you figure out what happened. Now, what all do you remember?
I was in Ohio with Frisco. And that's where I met you. It was at that bar, the hat trick. And then he got really sick. And I stayed with him at the motel. And then I used his rental car and I took off. And I got a flat tire. And then, I don't know, everything kind of goes fuzzy from there.
Yeah, I'm sure it does. That's where I found you. I know you were. You were laying at the side of the road with this big bump on your head. I took you into this old farmhouse and I tried to take care of you.
I remember thinking that I was Phoebe. Was she there when it happened?
She split. I think she went back home.
Why?
She She was scared, maybe. She was a little, jealous.
Well, why did you continue to let me believe that I was Phoebe?
I didn't know who you were. I mean, we weren't introduced back at the hat trick, and there was no ID on you.
Maybe you saw me with Frisco. Well, why didn't you just take me back to the hat trick?
Yeah, I saw you with that guy. It didn't look like you wanted to be with him. You guys weren't on the best of terms when I saw you.
Yeah, well, you're right about that.
Yeah.
Well, why didn't you help me?
Help you?
Mm-hmm.
That's what I thought I was doing. I mean, look at it from my side. There you are. You're laying there on the side of the road, right? I take you in. I try to take care of you. When you wake up, you don't know who you are. I don't know who you are. But yeah, I let you think you were Phoebe. What? You want me to leave you in the road to rot? What?
No, of course not.
All right, it wasn't that bad. Now, was it?
No.
All right.
I just don't understand your motives. I think that you were using me.
I never laid a hand on you.
No, I didn't mean it like that. You used me as a shill. You used me with your con.
I used you. Yes, I did do that. But we needed the money. That's how we got the money.
I was pretty good, wasn't I?
Yeah, you were the best.
And we're clear.
Thanks, Tim.
Absolutely.
Appreciate it. Well, what do you think?
Yeah.
You got through to her?
I think it was very good. You were both very straightforward, and I'm sure she'll reply to something like that. Yeah, I think so, too, you know. And you guys were wonderful. I think the hotline was a great idea. And if Felicia heard it, I'm sure she'll be calling you.
Why didn't you tell us you were doing this?
Yeah.
You want to answer my question?
And Colton, why didn't you tell me? You came all the way over there to see me this afternoon. You told me you hadn't heard a thing, and now you were planning to do this all the time.
Why? Because I didn't want to get you upset.
Well, you goof, because I am upset. I
told you need to stay at home.
I want to know what's going on. I think I'll check the phone lines to see if Felicia might be calling in.
Thank you.
Yeah.
If she can.
What does that mean?
Well, it means that she may not be able to. No telling what this guy Decker's done to her.
Why do you go blaming Decker? You don't have any proof of that. Colton, are you going to let him talk about your brother like that?
Half-brother, and yes, I am.
Well, where's your loyalty? You don't care anything about your family?
Everybody just calm down for a second, all right?
Calm down.
Right.
There isn't anything we can do until we hear from her.
You're right.
Or someone telling us where they are. And then when we find her, then we'll question Decker.
Oh, question Decker, is it? How do you know he even had anything to do with this?
We don't know. We just have to find them, and then we'll get to the bottom of it.
Well, there's nothing.
What can we do while we're just waiting? Did you ever get in touch with your husband? You know, I wanted those photographs to Decker.
No, I couldn't find the weasel. And all I've got are those baby pictures of it.
It's not going to do us anything.
Okay, well, you know what he looks like, don't you? And you obviously do. So why don't we get a police artist down here and we'll have a composite made?
That's a great idea.
Yeah, it is. I can get it out of the wire service immediately.
Well, that's what I was hoping.
That's about all we can do. Maybe somebody will identify Decker.
I'll call the station.
Okay.
There he goes again.
Hello, Jason.
Decker.
Calm down. We're all tense because we're worried about Felicia.
And Decker.
Were you really scared for me at that biker bar?
Hell no. Scared for myself. And those guys had you made out of their little sister. Figured one wrong move out of me, I would have been a seat cover on some Harley. Some big guy sitting on me.
I'm sorry.
No, was it your fault? You didn't know any better?
I was so naive.
Innocent.
Yeah, but you changed all that. You taught me how to shill at three-card Monty. You taught me how to play the shell game. You taught me how to cheat at poker. I'm surprised we didn't go to jail.
Nah. We're too good for that.
I broke the law.
Ah, you bent the law. You didn't break the law. We broke the law, but it was fun, right?
Nobody back home would ever believe it in a million years.
Yeah, well, nobody back home. I don't think they need to know. Nobody got hurt.
No.
Like the man says, you can't cheat an honest man.
Yeah, you're right.
I know.
You can only con people when they're trying to con you,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. I mean, those marks that got conned, they can't go to the cops, right? I mean, there are exceptions, yeah.
What exceptions?
Well, Atlantic City, remember that envelope, that bill switch we tried to do? Yeah, that right there. Remember you picking that guy Jimmy's pocket? I mean, those aren't cons, those are crimes.
Yeah. It was bad of me, wasn't it?
I have a feeling that, Felicia and Phoebe are nothing alike.
They're not. I think it's time that Felicia loosened up a little bit.
Yeah, well, you got the costumes here for that.
I don't think that loose. You know, I can't believe I went out in public looking like this.
Yeah, and I got the... I got the photos to prove it.
Oh, you do? You still have that?
Yeah, come
on. Oh, look at that one.
What, this one?
Yeah. I look like I just ate a lemon, don't I?
Yeah.
You want to keep these?
You keep one, I'll keep one, and we'll both remember. How about?
Okay. Yeah. Remember the good times. Like how much you helped me and took care of me.
No problem. Don't think about it, all right? So what, now that you know who you are, you're heading out?
I have to. If you only knew what I'm going to face when I go home.
No, none of my business.
Yes.
Unless you want to tell me.
No, I have to work it out for myself.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
Yeah. If everybody back home were as easygoing as you... Never mind. I'm gonna pack.
Chin's not right.
No, the chin's okay. It's the eyes. You haven't captured his eyes.
Hair's wrong. Hair should be darker.
You can adjust the chin and narrow the nose. We'll have it.
I don't agree about the chin. Well,
that's just not it. You make my son look like a common criminal. Well,
what the hell you think he is?
He is not.
No, can we just stop arguing about this and get it right?
I don't think your mother wants to do that.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means I don't think you want us to find your little boy.
I certainly do want to find him. It's the only way we're going to prove him innocent. He didn't have anything to do with Felicia's disappearance.
Look, okay, folks, I can't work like this.
Yep, this guy's right. You're having problems here. Would you work better if all these people weren't around you?
I'd love it, and I'll call you when I have something.
Disperse, friends.
I know this isn't easy for you.
Honey, it's not easy for any of us. All we're trying to do is just do the best for somebody we love.
You mean Decker?
Of course I mean Decker. He's my son, and I love him.
You think you could calm down? You're making me a wreck.
It's just been too long, Tony. If she could have, she would have called by now.
You don't know that. Maybe she didn't see the show.
She saw it. It's just that she can't do anything about it, that's all. She can't do anything about it. She can't call.
You don't have any proof about that.
I got all the proof I need. Has she called? No.
I don't understand. Why are you so pessimistic?
Because I'm scared.
Colton and Charlene think this is about as close as it's going to get. What do you think? I can send it out over the wire if it's close, at least.
This is it. That's our boy, Decker Moss. Get it out as soon as you can, Tiffany. Thanks.
Okay, I'm going to go live with this first, okay?
Yep.
Okay. Could you set up? Get everybody set up. We've got a camera, so we're going to go live.
Sure, right away. All right, everybody, let's move.